the sparks were flying. Anyone who was at YouTube went to next, they knew that this was more than just, you know what I mean? They knew something brutal.
It's like watching the night sky or a beautiful sunrise. Well, there's so much they hold. And just like them old stars, I see that you've come so far to be right where you are. How old is your soul? Well, I won't give up on us, even if the skies get rough. I'm giving you all my love. I'm still.
But what I love about these two and spending time with these two is that not only was it them two, but they could open their arms to me, and it was me and them, and it wasn't like them and then me, it was all of us, all together, all the time.
I want my sons to call you mama, my girls to be like you. I wanna see you every morning, I wanna hear you say I do. And it's nice to finally know where all those prayers go. I've been asking God for you, coming in your love with me. Even though I'm not a hero, could you love me anyway?
I need someone to go and affirm my need for ice cream. Or if I just want to have fun and have a good laugh, you know, we were hanging out the other day and Jason said, Katie and Heather, you guys are really different when you're together.
Father God, we are so thankful for this day, for this occasion, and for your two children who are standing here before me. God, we thank you for a place like this, that we can have a day like this. We humbly ask for your blessing on these people, on this wedding, and more importantly, on this marriage. We recognize and give you praise for your sovereignty in all things, that you knew this day was coming long before we did. And we trust that you have been preparing these two for everything that their lives together will bring. We love you and we trust you with all that we have and all that we are. In Jesus' name.
Thank you.
gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Take you, Heather, to be my wife. I promise to love you forever and ever. I vow to be your rock and hold you close in hard times. I will respect you and honor you, even when I may think you're wrong. I promise to provide for you and be the godly husband you deserve. When we have been all over the world together, but the amount of miles traveled does not equal the amount of love I have for you. I cannot wait to spend the rest of my life with you, to further grow my love for you.
It's right now. I, Heather, take you, Jason, to be my husband. I vow to walk by your side through the triumphs and challenges the Lord has planned for us. I vow to love you more every day and promise to do my best to do everything you deserve. I vow to nurture and love our children as you have loved me, and I vow to be the best wife that I can be. I come into this marriage with all that I am. It's not the end of a search, it's the beginning of a new adventure. I will be yours alone as long as we both shall live.
My faith and our strength together. Faith and our strength together.
Faith and strength together.
And my promise to learn and grow with you.
And I promise to live together.
Faith and our strength together, and my promise to learn and grow with you.
And I promise to learn and grow.
So, Jason, do you take Heather to be your lawfully wedded wife to live together after all of God's ordinances in holy matrimony? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, and will keep yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Heather, do you take Jason to be your lawfully wedded husband to live together after all of God's ordinances in holy matrimony? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others? And will you keep yourself only unto him as long as you both shall live?
Yeah.
Part of our responsibility as witnesses to these vows, these promises, is to aid whenever and wherever we can to help these two keep these words that they've spoken today. Thank you. I now pronounce you husband and wife. Jason, kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time, it is my great privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Jason Arbour.
Oh yeah. 105 is the number that comes to my head when I think of all the years I wanna be with you. Wake up every morning with you in my bed. That's precisely what I plan to do. And you know one of these days when I get my money right, buy you everything and show you all the finer things in life. We'll forever be in love, so there ain't no need to rush. But one day I won't be able to ask you loud enough. I'll say, well,
but anyways, to a long lasting, loving, and healthy community.
I have known them both before they actually started dating. Asked Jason to a high school dance one time. And we went to Heather's house, so I'm pretty sure, I think I might have been the one who did credit for it, but I wouldn't know. So I don't know if you guys know the story, but Heather went over to a friend's house, and she saw Jason across the room. I'd never met him before, and she said, no, it wasn't me, but it was a friend, and she said, I'm gonna marry that boy over there. And she remembers to this day that very moment, and she was so sure, and she didn't know, she'd never met him, and now Heather comes to me saying that as a 16-year-old girl. I would like to say that at the time I thought, Heather, that's silly, but the 16-year-old version of myself probably thought, oh my gosh, yeah! So, Heather said that, I probably didn't think much of it, and so I got to be the one who was hanging around while Heather had this huge crush on this boy, Jason. She talked about his blue eyes, she talked about his cute smile.
I've been a walking heartache, I've made a mess of me. The person that I've been lately ain't who I wanna be. But you stay here right beside me and watch as the storm blows through. And I need you, 'cause God gave me you for the ups and downs. God gave me you for the days of doubt. And for when I think I lost my way, there are no words here left to say it's true. God gave me you're seeing a divine conspiracy. That you, an angel lovely, would somehow fall for me. You'll always be love's great martyr, and I'll be the flattered fool.
In and my heart started skipping a beat. I was trying to play it cool, but I knew it was true that nobody would ever compete. Well, first comes love and then comes first date, first kiss. We were checking off the list and you were getting down on your knee. And you didn't have to guess, it was always a yes. Now there's two less fish in the sea. Let's set the date, let's hire a band, let's cut the cake. Yeah, I do's and the kisses from a miss to a missus. Can't wait for forever to stop. Let's